Well, I'm just going to say a few brief words about this symphony. I mean, it's one thing to have the nerve to call something a symphony and another to lecture an audience about it. So I'm just going to say why I attempted to do something like this. What I was trying to do was to see whether it was possible to use material of a kind of popular style, but also to use some of the techniques associated with symphonic writing. And you'll probably be aware that one of the things that has characterized symphony, especially since the works of Beethoven, which this is nothing like, incidentally, is an attempt to develop longer stretches from small amounts of material. So in the first movement, just the very beginning, that the flugelhorn plays a theme, and it begins da-da-da-da, and I'm trying to make that da-da-da-da move into longer sections, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then the second theme, I use more or less the same melody, but with different harmonies, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then finally, I bring in a different theme with a fandango rhythm that's dun 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 dun. Goodness knows why this was meant for celebrations in Salford and in my hometown of Todmorden in the Pennines. But anyway, I like fandango rhythm. And I also like Arthur Sullivan very much. And those of you that know your Gilbert and Sullivan will know that Sullivan really likes putting two different tunes together. So that's what happens in towards the end of the first movement. Then the second movement, this was something that I was trying to evoke the hills, the Pennines around the town of Todmorden where I live, and I got this tune, da 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 da. Unfortunately, I play the Highland bagpipe, and that's the kind of tune that quickly turns into da-da, 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 da-da. And I was mortified that the first time the piece was played where someone said, oh, it really conjures up the Pentlands for me. I said, no, the Pennines, not the Pentlands. But so it has this Scottish element that sort of got into it. Then the scherzo. For some reason, I went for one of these rumpty-tumpty-tumpty scherzos. This kind of thing that annoys me in some Vaughan Williams is the rumpty dumpty scherzo. And then I thought, well, wait a minute, the dum 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 dum, one, two, one, two. What if I put another straight rhythm against it so I can go da dum da 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 dum da dum da 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 dum? And I thought, da 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 da. So we've got these 2 meters going on at once. And then the finale, seems to have a lot of minor key in it, but I don't know why. It's a long time since I wrote it. But the da 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 in the finale changes da 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 da. I widen the interval a little bit, and then what's the other thing to watch? Yeah, sadly in the finale I became aware symphonies are serious. Maybe I should do something serious. I mean, Mozart wrote this brilliant finale of the Jupiter Symphony, and I thought, wait a minute, I'll put a fugue in it. Unfortunately, I'm not Mozart, but the fugue is there. And I thought, well, it was written that celebrating an academic occasion, there's nothing more academic than a fugue, so there you are, love it or leave it. That's it, thanks.
The first symphony, of course there will be an interval of 20 minutes, I'm sure that we're going to enjoy Symphony number 1.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.